Hello students, in previous video I explained you lesson number 12, the pie and the tart, which is written by Hugh Chesterman. This one is a one act play. So today we start our exercise. Now go to the vocabulary from exercises. Question number 1 is, choose the appropriate alternatives to complete the sentences given below. So there is some alternatives is given, so we have to choose the correct one. Charity begins at house or home? Home. Second, I claim to be first or second to none in all Paris? Answer is second. Third, I will get odd or even with him for it one day, mark my words. Answer is even. He couldn't find dash enough to thank me. Sentences or words? Words. We make a pretty pair. I and you and I. Answer is you and I. Now here some words in question number 2. Make sentences with each of the following words and phrases so as to bring out its meaning. So you have to use these words in sentences. Like first one is prefer. You make sentence, I prefer milk to tea. Second, budge an inch. You make sentence, an honest man does not budge an inch in the face of corruption. Third one is out of sight. Sentences, out of sight, out of mind is a common proverb. Run errands. Sentences, she was tired of running errands for her relative. Now students, go to comprehension section. Question A, answer the following questions in about 25 words each. Question number 1 is, what makes Jean and Pyra a pretty pair? Answer is, the tattered and insufficient dress makes Jean and Pyra a pretty pair. Besides, both of them are cheats and hungry. The miserable circumstances of their life too make them a pretty pair. Here, question number 2 is, Pyra was very much worried about the holes in his tunic. What was Jean concerned about? Answer is, Pyra was very much concerned about 23 big holes in his tunic, whereas Jean was not interested in him. He was concerned about his hunger. Question number 3. What reason did Gualter give for not giving alms to Pyra? Answer. The reason that Gualter gave for not giving alms to Pyra was that he had got nothing for him. Beside, his wife was out and he was very busy. Question number 4. Why did Gualter not carry the eel pie when he went to dine with the mayor? Answer. The reason that Gualter did not carry the eel pie when he went to dine with the mayor because that he would lose his reputation if people saw him carrying an eel pie through the streets of Paris. Question number 5. Gualter had told Marion that way to identify the right messenger. What was it? Answer. Gualter told his wife Marion that the right messenger would kiss her hand. That would be a sign that everything was all right. Question number 6. Whom did Marion give the pie to and why? Answer. Marion gave the pie to Pyra because Pyra projected himself as the right messenger by kissing the hand of Marion. Question number 7. Gaspard Gualter is not the man to be treated like that. Why did Gualter say so? Answer is, Gualter made the above sentence because he was a man of position. The mayor had invited him for dinner but was out. So it was a great dishonor to him. Question number 8. How did Pyrrha come to know about the tart? Answer. When Pyrrha went to Gualter's door for alms and knocked at the door, he saw tart on a shelf just outside the kitchen. Thus, he came to know about the tart. Question number 9. Why was Gualter angry with Marian? Answer. Gualter was angry with Marian because he asked her to send the eel pie with the messenger, but she had not sent any messenger. He had to return home hungry. Question number 10. How did Pyrrha escape the ire of Gualter? Answer. Pyrrha told Gualter that he had overheard the couple's talk. So he took the eel pie to the mayor's house. The mayor felt very grateful and was hoping him for the dinner. Gualter was very happy to hear this. Thus, Pyrrha escaped from the ire of Gualter. So students, these are the answers of your 25 words. So you have to find all the answers in your book. When you read lesson carefully, you get all the answers. So your homework is to read the lesson and write the answers in your fair notebook.